In darkness they came. Their destination, the Games Academy somewhere out at sea. Their mission, to become games playing legends and to crack the challenge of Games Master.
Semi-finals. We've got 9 teams have got through, 3 of which will be competing tonight. The winning team, well, they go through to their place in the final where they're going to have a chance to win loads of mega prizes, believe me, as well as the title of Games Master Team Champions. Yeah. Oh, nice one. All right, come on, let's go and meet the team. Stop hanging about. This way. Yeah. This team before, I happen to know that they're called the Gits, aren't you guys?
That's right.
Come on, tell us your names.
Steve.
Snell.
Brad.
Right, here they all are, the Gits. You did quite well in the first round, didn't you, in your heat? So how are you going to do on the semis?
Yeah, we're going to cane everyone.
Well, he's absolutely serious about it. Give him a big round of applause and we're going to meet the next team we're up against. We've seen them before as well. Tell us your names.
Sam,
all right, Sam?
Paul.
How you doing, Paul?
Matthew.
So, how do you think you're going to do?
Well, in the practice, they're about the same as us, so we'll do all right.
About the same. Is that true, lads? About the same?
No,
they don't seem to think so. Well, good luck to you anyway. I'm sure you're going to need it. All right, let's go and meet the next team. Give them a big cheer. Wake up. It's the dream team. I'm sure they got their posse with them, they did have last time. Got your posse here?
Yep.
Go on, tell us your names.
Chris.
Say hello to the people at home.
Robert.
James.
All right, how are you going to do? Tell us about tonight's show. What are you going to do?
We're going to outclass all of them. We're just the top.
Your top team, yeah?
Yep.
Top team?
Kick-ass, yeah.
I don't know if you can say that, but he said it anyway. Right, give him a big round of applause. Yeah. Okay. But for the semi-finals, we're going to go back to the old classics just to make things really good. So, Games Master, tell us what tonight's first classic is going to be.
For tonight's first classic challenge, I've selected the high-tech and well-loved Star Wing for the Super Nintendo. Our contestants have 45 seconds to score as many points as possible by destroying enemy craft with their smart bombs or blasters. Additional points can be got by steering the spaceship through the hoops. I'll award 5 points to the team with the highest score, 2 for second place, and 0 for the losers.
Okay, so the game is Star Wing. Steve of the Gits is up first. Dave, is he any kind of pilot or is he rubbish or what?
Well, Star Wing's a great game. Unfortunately, Steve's not a great player. In the previous heats of the challenges, he actually lost on Mean Beam Machine.
So
he's probably the wobbliest member of his side.
He's got 45 seconds to score as many points as he can. Okay then, Steve, you Git, start your challenge. Off you go, mate, good luck.
Here
he comes and he's away. Right, the time starts now. He's off and flying.
In there goes the thing to look out for. It's the shield bar in the bottom left-hand corner.
51 points.
That's the energy bar for Steve's ship.
If that gets through there,
he's going to clear his
blast. Drops the Nova.
He's got to go through all these little arches. He's used the supernova bombs to score everything. He also picks up some extra supernova bombs.
25 seconds gone. He's flying like a bit of a
mini game. He's doing everything right so far.
Again, picks up
that's 1,000 points. He gets 1,000 points on that one because he went through all the arches cleanly.
25 seconds gone.
Steve's doing very well.
Seconds left.
Well, I think Paul's going to let his nerves get to him because he's a very good player and he'll be looking to bust that score wide open.
OK, the best of luck to him. He's got 45 seconds to get as many points as he possibly can. OK, then, start your challenge. OK, I'm getting ready to start the clock. He's away. He's off and running. Here he goes.
Ball's on his way.
There he goes.
He's got to shoot everything.
He's got to take something out.
And he's got to get
out
through those hoops. Here he goes. That's the arch. Here we go, Dan.
Down
in the left hand corner, that's his shield. The more damage he takes, the lower that gets.
And he could have
lost. Supernova bomb. He clears everything on the screen. He's got that because he went through the arches clearly. That's his extra 1,000 points. He's doing extremely well so far. Weaving things, but he wants to find some points. 5 meter shoot.
1st in the Elfmania challenge that we had a few heats back, but he's a very cool player and he's seen what everyone else has done. He knows where all the points are and I expect him to get very close to that score.
All right then, good luck to you, Christopher, and start your challenge now.
Yeah, let's go. Off they go, screaming into the challenge. Christian knows what it's going to take. He's got to go through these arches. He knows he's going to do it. Around him away, get those extra points.
Keep on going, 3,000, 4,000.
He's going through all the arches, he's going
20
for the big
seconds
point.
Gone.
And he's doing very, very well.
Blasters. He's got 30 seconds gone.
Shooting away, blasting away. He's going
to
hit that ring for another 1,000 points.
He's doing well, nice
7,000,
10 seconds left. Come on, Chris, make your moves.
Doing
man.
Extremely well.
He's five,
that's a
four,
missile gone away. Supernova
three,
bomb.
Two,
extra points.
One,
that's the
stop
end of his challenge.
In third position is the Dream Team. They didn't do so well on that challenge. They've got no points. In second position is the Gits. They've got 2 points. But in front at the moment is the Hawks with 5 points. Give them a cheer. OK, things are hotting up. We've got another challenge to come along. But before we get that going, why don't you check out some reviews? Tonight we take a look at the new Nintendo football games, beginning with Virtual Soccer, a sports sim that tries to take the ball away from the opposition with a four-player simultaneous play and a choice of player speeds.
Virtual Soccer kicks off in good style with a great selection of strips and a great selection of view angles.
You get different chants across the world, you get the chance for unlimited fouls if the ref isn't on screen, and you get some nice Mode 7 graphics on the pitch.
One player boring, two player so-so, middle of the road. If you stay there for much longer, it's going to get hit by a truck.
What would it be like to play in a footy game where the teams were 15 foot tall? Well, that's what you've got when it comes to Empire Soccer, which attempts to breathe new life into your boots. Give it all you've got, lads.
Well, you've got some very funny, cartoony sprites, burly little fellas who amble around. You've got a very strange-shaped pitch. It's square, and it has vast goals.
There's a lot of special moves which you don't see in other soccer games, such as the banana kick. It's absolutely wild.
Empire Soccer is absolutely massive. And I say it's massive, it's one of those games that doesn't take itself too seriously.
Aliens have kidnapped the World Cup. Liberty. Get it back in soccer, kid. You've got 15 levels of meaty field action with only a ball at your feet to save the day and find footy's greatest prize.
You can kick the ball in the air, dribble it around, knock people off the skateboards, take out Rottweilers.
Graphics spot on, sound spot on.
It's a platform game with a difference. If you can master the control mechanism, you're on for a good time.
Was fresh and funky and it was happening for you there in the reviews. Right, time for the second challenge. So let's go to the games whilst I find out exactly what it's going to be.
For this evening's platform game, it gives me great pleasure to welcome back an old friend, Sonic the Hedgehog for the Sega Mega Drive. The task is simple. Race to the end of the Green Hill Zone in the quickest time and the victory will be yours. As usual, 5 points will be awarded to the team with the fastest time, 2 to second place, and 0 to the losers. Jump to it.
Right, James is up first for the Dream Team, isn't he? Yep, so what's his platform form like then, Dave?
Well, James actually came first his previous heat on Dragon's Revenge, which is a pinball game, so maybe he'd been happier if this had been Sonic Spinball. Yeah. But if you can't play Sonic, you don't deserve to be on the show anyway.
Couldn't agree with you more, Dave. It's only the first level, and you've got to get through it as quick as you possibly can. OK, then, James, Start your challenge! Go on, Sonic.
Yeah, right, so the way he races our little spiky.
Off he goes. Good leap.
Good leap. He's got to get some rings. It's a good idea to get some rings.
It's all about time. Nicely cleared that lap.
Good move. Sonic's got a ring. He can't be killed.
Go, don't want to stop.
He hasn't got way back collected too many. He's just going to get through. Ringing and running. Getting his speed up.
Go on, he's going
all the way behind him. That's good. Bouncing off the baddies over chasm. Saved Jim going down.
23 seconds.
He's not far off.
Bradley's chances, do you reckon?
30 seconds is a great time.
Yeah.
It's going to take a very good performance to beat it.
Yep, it's going to be a tough time to beat. Good luck, Bradley. Everyone's counting on you. OK, mate, start your challenge! Yeah. Here he goes. Oh, good move, good move!
Yeah, there we are, he's got the rings.
Keep going!
He has to have some rings, because obviously if he gets hit without the rings, he's going to die.
Oh, this is good, Dave.
Now he's got some rings, he hasn't got to worry about collecting anything else.
Stop it, stop.
He just charged through the level.
Keep going, come on, Sonic, come on, Sonic.
That's it, keep going, Sonic.
Run like the wind!
Every chance.
Round
20 seconds
now.
Left.
Well, good
manoeuvre. By the end of
good style.
This is great for getting your speed
like
up.
A lizard.
Straight through
keep
the air.
Right. 26 seconds. Gone.
All he's got to do is make sure he
so
has a bump
close.
To anything to slow him down.
29.
29 seconds. No.
30
seconds. They've drawn.
Well, Bradley of the Gits got 30 seconds as well. Bit of a tiebreaker situation at the moment. Next up is Matthew of the Humberside Hawks. Dave, is he going to be 30 seconds? Are we going to see a 29er?
Well, Matthew's the only one of the competitors in this challenge who didn't actually win his heat. He only came second on Magic Boy. Oh. And he's going to need some real magic to beat 30 seconds. That seems to be the time.
So good luck, guys, and start your challenge. Off you go. Run, okay. Run!
Off he goes, Matthew, charging away.
Good leap.
There's very little to say about
well
this
time.
Game. Everybody
and
knows
again.
It.
Oh.
Everybody loves it. Well, most people love it.
That's going to blow it for him, Dave.
Go to the
got
right.
Terrible feeling about this one now.
Well, he's bumped into a few things and you can't afford to be static for a minute when you're playing
you've
at this level. And he's not up to top speed.
Come there on, goes Sonic.
He needs this turbo boost now.
Move it!
Off he goes up into the air. Of course, that's a waste
he's
of time. There's nothing
he's
to do about
30
that.
Seconds is over.
Seconds. He's our loser on this challenge. 33
seconds by Matthew. Pretty good score. Let's go to the scoreboard and see what the current standings really are. The Hawks got none in the last challenge, but they got five in the first one. That means they got five overall. Then the Dream Team, where they scored five in the last challenge, but none in the first one. That means they got five overall as well. But the Gits got two in the first challenge and five in this challenge. That means they've got seven overall. We've got a tiebreaker situation between the Dream Team and the Hawks. Yeah! We've got to go to the Games Master, find out what a tiebreaker challenge is going to be.
Gosh, this is really exciting. For the tiebreaker, I've chosen World Heroes 2 for the Neo Geo. A fearsome beat-em-up with some particularly devastating special moves. The contestant who pummels his opponent into submission after a single round will be the victor.
So it's a good bit of beat-em-up action with World Heroes 2. We've got Sam of the Hawks and Chris of the Dream Team. They're both in position. Dave, tell us a bit about their characters, will you, mate?
Well, Sam's going to be playing as the martial artist King Dragon, while Chris has chosen to be the pirate fighter Captain Kidd. Two very different characters. We should be in for a good bow.
Oh, shiver me timbers, me hearties. OK, boys, start your challenge! Off you go!
OK, Captain Kidd is on the left, that's Chris. Sam is King Dragon, he's on the right, looking like Bruce Lee. That was a special
Sam
move.
The Hawks.
That was like a thousand hand slap ready on her. And look at that punch raining in. Those are some serious damage. The energy
big
bars
licks
at the top of the screen as they
Sam
go from yellow
big
to purple.
Like
so
Lee.
The fighters are losing their energy
like
and are slowly
Lee.
Becoming
well.
Beaten.
Catch
and at the moment, it's Captain Kidd that's losing it. And
look
he's gone.
Go.
It's history. It's all over for Christian.
OK, Sam and the Hawks is the winner. Let's go and say bye-bye to the Dream Team. Dream team. What happened? Were you asleep in that challenge or what?
We had to let someone else win, you know. We didn't deserve the prizes because...
You didn't deserve the prizes? What,
no,
you didn't want to win them?
No, they're not good enough for us, sorry.
Oh, well, I think there's only one course of action we can take. Eject them from the premises, caretaker. Chuck them out. Get rid of them. Far too flash. Didn't have the style to pull it off. All right, then. Right, we're going into a little commercial break, but stay with us because we've got a celebrity challenge after that. Also, we've got these two teams battling it out for a place in the final.
Thank you.
for our celebrity challenge. Please give a big cheer and a big warm welcome to Two Unlimited. Right in the middle. For Two Unlimited, hasn't it?
Yeah, I think it was the best year. We had a number one album, number one single, so...
So yeah. Things are going well, you're happy with it?
Yeah, sure. Yeah.
And Lee, I hear you're a bit of a games player, is that right?
Ah, it's true, yeah.
Yeah, you got a computer?
I've got a Nintendo at home, right?
Yeah?
Yeah.
All right then, well, let's go to the Games Master, find out what Two Unlimited's challenge is gonna be.
For tonight's celebrity challenge, I've chosen the blistering beat-em-up Fatal Fury 2 for the Neo Geo. Our pop-tabulous contestants will go head-to-head over three rounds of no-holds-barred fighting action. The contestant still standing will take home my glittering golden joystick.
So, the game is Fatal Fury 2, an old classic that we love. A good old chestnut here. Dave, how do you think Two Unlimited are going to do?
It's a great game, but first off, do you think I could get my hair done like that? Will I get Games Master across the back?
No, Dave, I don't think so.
Well, Ray's going to be playing as Joe Higashi, and Anita will be playing as Mai. And although I hate to bet on girls, I'm putting my money on Anita on this one.
OK, Dave, well, fair enough. That's up to you, mate. Right then, good luck to both the guys. Start your challenge. Yeah!
OK, Anita is Mai on the left-hand side of the screen.
Right, and we've got Ray on the right-hand
Ray
side.
Ray on the right is Joe Higashi.
Yeah.
Well, thanks to watch out for the energy
right.
bars at the top
right.
of the
Take
screen.
The
more
good
yellow you see, the healthier the character is. The yellow wears down, so
kick.
The character's getting into trouble. And then the tourists are hard to beat because they're good
Stick
in the air. With a lightning punch followed by an uppercut. And that takes an awful lot of energy off the character. Whoever gets the next big challenge blows in.
Ray
leaves in. Anita's gone in. Joe Gash is going in for the kill. That's going to be it for Anita, surely.
First round to Ray. What do you say, Ray? Nice one.
Okay, second round. Anita means business. She goes leaving in. Gash's face. For Ray. So Ray comes straight back. Special move, lightning punches to the face. You don't want to walk into Joe Higashi when he's pulling that one. A lovely low kick from Joe Higashi. And that's the lightning move. May jump straight into it. It's going to be out. Oh, that's a good move. That's a good move. They're both being low. Joe Higashi suffering. He's got to get one blow. All Nia's got to do is get one blow in on Ray. And we're going to just do one all. One blow. That's it. No. No. No, he got her. Next blow's going to win it.
Come on.
That could be it.
For both of our contestants. Yeah! Okay, okay. And he didn't give you much of a chance, really, did he?
It's the character. The character was much too strong for mine.
Yeah, he had a bit of character.
It was.
You wanted to win that joystick, didn't you, Ray?
Yeah, I wanted to.
Well, you have won the Games Master Golden Joystick. Let's get the caretaker on to give you your joystick. Brought to you by Games Master. Now we're going over to the consultation zone so he can help the luckless.
Greetings. I am again ready to put a few more poor souls on the straight and narrow. Who's our first lost cause?
Games Master, on Kevin Keegan's Player Manager on Super Nintendo, I've got a very settled squad, but I keep getting loads of transfer requests. What can I do?
Poor Kevin. You are having problems, aren't you? Well, you can always give your team a bonus. The bigger the bonus, the happier the team. If you can't afford that, then why not give them some time off training? They could possibly do with a break.
Games Master, I'm stuck on the first stage of level 2 and James Bond the Jewel and the Mask System. Can you help me, please?
This is an easy one. Go to the far right of the level and stand on the cue cases. Turn right and shoot. After about 5 shots, a secret platform will appear. Jump on this and you will find yourself whisked to the top of the level.
Thanks, Games Master. You're the best.
Who's last?
Games Master, on Kevin Keegan's Player Manager on Super Nintendo, My team are in the doldrums. What can I do to lift the morale?
Frankly, Kevin, you're wasting your time. You obviously have no aptitude for the game. Ever thought of tennis?
Oh, you're a lifesaver. Thanks, Games Master.
That's enough happiness spread for one day. I'm off. Bye.
You see, you're never alone in a consultation zone. Right then, we've got two teams left. They're battling out for a place in the final. So, Neil, what do you think of this team then, eh?
Chicago Bulls says it all, mate.
Says it all, yeah. What about this lot? What do you think?
Well, they are the Gits, so they're hardly going to win with a name like that, are they?
Whack, 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 whack. Right, OK, there's a bit of competition building up here. Let's go up to the Games Master, see what the challenge is going to be.
For tonight's final, our teams will go head-to-head on the timeless classic Mario Kart for the Super Nintendo. The first team past the finishing line after five laps will qualify for a place in the championship final.
Right, good. This is one of my favourite games, Super Mario Kart. So Neil from the Gits is up against Sam from the Hawks. Dave, tell us what characters they're driving or playing.
Well, Sunil is going to play as Toad, and Toad. Sam is going to play as Koopa Troopa, and both these characters are evenly matched, so we can have a fairly competitive race, I think.
Yes, let's show no mercy to the opposing team. Go for it, guys. Good luck, and start your challenges. Five laps.
Koopa Troopa is the little pink one on the left-hand side of the screen. Toad is the one with a mushroom on his head.
Come on, Sunil.
Have to go over these coins. Question marks.
So, they both got
little icons.
Shoot them up there.
Little arrows that they can use at some point during the game.
At
the
moment, oh yes, nicely taken.
Both used them so far.
Good move.
Now, at the moment, Toad is in the lead.
Power up.
He's got over what icons he's going to get. He's got some
points.
He's
used
them
instantly
to try and get some extra speed for his car.
He just goes faster and faster and faster.
He's going to check it.
Good driving.
He shoots past Toad.
Good driving. Come on, Toad.
And Toad's got some really serious driving to do. He's got a mushroom,
he can speed up with that.
Oh no, he got hit.
He can speed up with that mushroom.
Left by Toad. He's
but
crashed.
Sam could take that with a guided shell there. Has guided that shell. He'll go straight for his opponent.
Koopa Troopa is miles away in the lead at the moment. And Toad is really struggling.
Snail's got it all to make
crashing.
Up. What's
an
he got?
Awful lot.
Star, hit a star.
Not doing very
go
well.
For it. Yes,
he's got the star.
It's the final lap.
Racing ahead.
Go on, Sunil, you're getting there. Good jump.
But he's just crashing. He's not doing very well, and he's not really making any dent
come
on Koopa Troopa's lead. This is going to be an easy win for Koopa Troopa.
He's doing
very, very well. And he's won. No problems for Koopa Troopa.
Sam, Sunil, you git. What went wrong, mate? He's not a happy man.
Well, I don't know. He's got the better weapons, I guess.
Yeah, he took you out a bit nastily, didn't he?
Yeah.
He was doing quite well for a minute there. Unlucky gits, I'm afraid. We have to get rid of you. You're out. But these guys, you're through to the final! This is one of our teams for the final, the first team for the final. Are you pleased?
Definitely.
What, you're going to have it all to do in the final? You're up for them prizes?
Yeah.
You excited?
Yeah, easy.
Yeah, it's going to be easy, is it?
Yeah, easy so far.
Easy so far. Well, let's hope it's not too easy for them in the final. Right, OK, we've got one team for the final. We need two more. So next week, we're going to find out who the second team for the final is. So tune in then and check it out for our second semi-final. Right, give us a big